Welcome back to Morning Live. Now, yoga is known as a physical, mental, and spiritual practice started in India. It's not quite popular with Kenyans despite the numerous efforts to have majority of Kenyans adopt this practice that is known to have effectiveness in dealing with lifestyle and fitness.
It is a practice that engages the core, the mind, the body. The word yoga comes from Sanskrit and means to join or unite, symbolizing the union of body and consciousness. And clearly, participants in today's class are enjoying the World International Yoga Day.
Notice I've been through menopause and no weight gain, nothing. So no mood swings. I've always been calm, I think, after doing yoga.
It feels so nice. It's impressive. In fact, these days, this culture, this, you know, the lifestyle is very bad this time. When you feel in that yoga, you can feel the difference. Health-wise, mind-wise, your body-wise. And these days, everyone is always coming to yoga.
Yoga is life. Make it part of your life. It's very important to incorporate or integrate yoga in your life. And it balances your mind, your body, and your soul. It's beyond religion.
After being recognized due to its international appeal by United Nations on December 11, 2014, people who practice the craft have since celebrated the day. Today, it is practiced in various forms around the world and continues to grow in popularity.
With practicing the yoga or particular postures, your body not only get fit, but yoga helps to avoid many diseases to occur in the body.
I think because people think that it comes from India and people think because it comes with some of the hymns or mantras, so it must be a religious thing. It is not. It's basically an Indian practice. It's a practice that originates from India, but all it does is make you more aware of your mind, body, and soul. And we all have minds, we all have bodies, and we all have souls, regardless of color or regardless of religion or regardless of whatever our beliefs are.
Yoga International Days are occasioned to educate the public on issues of concern, to mobilize political will and resources to address global problems, and to celebrate and reinforce achievements of humanity. Salome Mwirore, Switch TV.
Welcome back. Now, in the studio, I'm joined by practitioners of yoga, and with me is Dr. Rajinder Prasad. Welcome to the show. I also have Dr. Sima Sharma.
Thank you.
And I have a practitioner, Ms. Farah Ismail.
Thank you.
So guys, what exactly is yoga, Dr. Rajinder?
Yoga is, the exact meaning of yoga is union, unity. Unity between who and whom? Mm-hmm. Body, mind, and spirit. Then the union between the spirit and the super soul is yoga.
Okay. Okay.
The actual word is yoga.
Okay.
Y-O-G.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay.
That is a yoga.
Dr. Sima, yeah. What is the difference between yoga and gym?
You see, in the gym, we are doing only muscular workout, and yoga is working on the all aspects of the body and the mind. And okay. It's working on all the systems of the body.
Yep.
And gym is only on the muscles and tones up.
Yeah.
So that is the difference, and it works on all the systems of the body.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Quite interesting. Farah, now, you're a practitioner. How many years have you done yoga?
Four or five years now.
Yeah. Five. Why yoga? And how does this coincide with your faith? Is there a clash?
No, there's no clash at all, because I'm so well connected, you know, even in the culture, the Muslim culture. It's not anything that I am, how do I say it? The faith is one thing, but mm-hmm. I'm spiritually, mentally, and physically connected with yoga.
Okay.
I feel really good. My body feels nice. Yeah. I don't see any difference with anything to do with faith.
Okay, okay. Now, Dr. Rajinder, there's a misconception that yoga is only for the Hindu, yeah, or for Asians.
Mm.
Why is this the case, and how do you demystify this?
See, we have had all these questions. Wherever we go to teach or teach this yoga, people, they say this originated from India. Yes, true. yoga originated from India, but physically and mentally, the systems of your body and my body is the same. Anatomical structure and the physiology of your body and my body is the same. Everybody needs to stay fit physically, mentally, and spiritually. So, I don't feel so that there is any discrimination between the religions and
just clarify. Is it how yoga came into the Orient, or is it how yoga came into Africa? Why are not many people taking up yoga? Maybe you can answer that question.
No, yoga is arisen from the India. And Africans are also doing now, it's a Afri yoga, maybe the foundation. They are doing under that, they are doing yoga now. But in the, which is originate from the India, we are also concentrate on the breathing and the meditation part and the concentration part. But which people are doing here, local people, they are only doing on the exercise, on the postures. So that is the difference which we are teaching. We are also working on the pranayams, breathings, mm-hmm. And on the all the meditation part.
Yeah. What does it take to become a yoga guru, and what is an Ayurvedic doctor?
Yeah. So I did the course in India. It's a yoga course, B.Ed. in yoga. I did in India,
yeah.
And I also did BMS. I am a bachelor in Ayurvedic medicine, yeah. And surgery.
Okay.
So that is the 6.5 year course,
okay.
And yoga is 1 year's course.
Okay.
So I did both courses. Yeah. So I'm lucky, okay. That I did both.
So Farah, how does yoga fit into your lifestyle?
Well, I started yoga. When I started yoga, I looked at it as nothing to do with religion or just for my own well-being. And that's exactly what I did. It has helped me physically. I've become more flexible. I'm calm. There's no anxiety, you know, and it's a great benefit,
yeah.
Especially working under, you know, working with the right team and the right people to teach, mm-hmm. you that, mm-hmm. then that is a plus,
yeah.
Right? So,
all right, fair enough. Dr. Rajinder, I'll just take that question again. Why is yoga popular only with people from the Asian descent and not other people?
You see, the difference between the Africans and the Indian, we have the cultural differences. So that's why Africans are slowly they are adopting. We have many Africans who are teaching yoga. We have a very big group of yoga instructors.
Sorry about that.
More than 50% are Africans, yeah. who are teaching yoga here.
Yeah.
So it is getting popular, and you might have seen now,
yeah.
we recently celebrated this International Yoga Day,
mm-hmm.
on 23rd June. Actually, it's on the 21st June.
And why 21st June?
Why 21st June? Because,
yeah.
you see, the countries at the Northern Hemisphere, the day 21st June is the longest day on that day. On that particular day, and also the countries at the Northern Hemisphere, they have something special on that particular day in,
yeah.
their own countries.
All right, so it's an equinox.
Yeah,
so that's right.
So now tell me, over the years, has yoga been receptive in Kenya, in your opinion, in East Africa?
Yes. Now, I told you, just we celebrated this International Yoga Day, and our teams were going to the churches, schools, and in the villages, just to teach them the basics of the yoga,
yeah.
And right now this concept is coming in the mind of our local people.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Fair enough. We're taking a short break now, but when we come back, Dr. Seema, you'll tell us more on the health benefits of yoga, and Farah, you'll tell us more about lifestyle and yoga.
Thank you.
Keep it Morning Live. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Morning Live. Now, Dr. Seema, what are the health benefits of yoga?
Yoga works on your body, mind, and the soul. So it's work on your all the body parts, all the hormones, all the systems of the body. So you become healthy, relaxed, and you are away from the stress, depression, anxiety. See, our lifestyle is like that. We all are suffering from some diseases due to the food, due to the stress, and we all are under the stress, anxiety, depression. So yoga help us to we stay away from the stress, anxiety, and from the diseases.
All right, so
it's only not a cure, it's also prevent the diseases.
Exactly. So bringing me to the question, does it boost your immune system? Does it ensure that blood flow goes faster?
Yeah, so
and how does this work medically?
See, it's in the breathing, it's increased the blood circulations, it's pure the blood in the body, and it's also boost up our energy level.
Okay.
And we become healthy and we relaxed.
Okay. So if
and a glow as well.
Everybody carries glow.
The beautiful glow, you know.
You can't even judge the age of the yoga practitioner from her or his face.
Yes.
That how old is he? But I'm not going to disclose the ages of this beautiful ladies.
Yes.
Let me add something.
Yeah.
See, everyone deserves peace of mind and good health.
Yeah.
Okay. So to maintain your health
and
peace of your body and also around your surroundings, yoga helps a lot.
Okay.
When you enter in the pose, in the posture, and you are focusing only at yourself.
Yeah.
Okay. So self-awareness is there that I can do this. I can do that.
Yeah.
So yoga is to unite body, mind, and spirit. Then after spirit with the super soul. When our soul is going to leave this body, our soul should leave the healthy body, not the sick body, or not at the ventilator or in coma.
Yeah.
So body should alter the that state should come when the body is going to alter the soul leave now.
Okay. So I have a question. Dr. Seymour, so does it mean if somebody has a medical condition and they're on medication, should they leave their medication and take yoga or
what exactly
do you advise?
Yeah, no, they keep the medication, but it's depend upon the instructor, how he's do the yoga therapy according to the stamina, according to the availability of the body. So he the yoga postures.
Yeah.
So you can do on the, if you can't sit down, you can sit on the chair and you can do it.
Yeah.
But is it a light exercise, it's not a competition.
Yeah.
You see, it's according to the disease, you can do the postures.
Incrementally.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Dr. Rajinda, what age groups do yoga, as young as how and as old as
any
how?
Any age group. Any age group. I am teaching yoga, and Farah knows, and she's the organizer of that institute, and it is called the Yoga for Seniors. I have 60 to 85 years old ladies group. Some are coming at the wheelchair, some are coming with the walker, some with the stick, but now slowly they are going away from the supports and doing themselves.
Okay.
So, doesn't matter any age group, and you are to perform the posture as well as your body allows. First of all, you have to listen to your body. It's not a competition. Rightly, she said that is not a competition. You are to listen to your body. Everybody has that different nature. So, you have to listen to your body.
Yeah. What diseases does yoga help combat or alleviate?
Yes, like chronic diseases, you ask that if a person is on the medication, yes, well, we don't tell the patient you leave the medicine or you taper down the medicine, reduce the dose of the medicine. No, never. When yoga is going to do the effect on her or his body, slowly she or he will get her reports. And then after they can decide that how to reduce or cut down the medicine.
Yeah.
So slowly, we have 2-3 ladies who are taking the medication for the thyroid.
Yeah.
But after 16 years, now they are
not taking the medicine.
Not any medicine. But then the doctors are also very much surprised that how it happened.
Yeah.
You see many chronic problems like hormonal imbalance, or diabetes, asthma, kidney problem, you have to continue with the medicine till your last breath.
All right. So now, Farah, this brings me as a practitioner. Is it the cost? Is it prohibitive? Is it friendly? How does one get into yoga? Do I need like gym clothes? Do I need a towel? Do I need a water bottle? Do I need like creatine?
You need the basic, very simple, basic stuff. You need a yoga mat, you could use your bed sheet, you could use a nice, comfortable blanket, and you can perform yoga. You don't even need shoes. In fact, I prefer performing yoga without even socks. So you're, you know, grounded to the earth. And that reminds you where you're coming from, you know. So that is important. And it's very basic. You need your towel, a little small towel, and really it's not expensive to do yoga. So I think people should practice yoga. My mother once said that, you know, if you complain and you keep complaining, you just become good at it. So I would tell everybody out there, keep practicing yoga and just become so good at it.
All right. So from your opinion, how many sessions should one have in a day, in a month, in a week?
You can do it every, you know, like 3 times a week. Or you can, if you want to do breathing, you can do breathing every day. Right, so you take about 10 minutes and just do like, you know, the breathing, which is part of yoga, right? And these are different pranayams, right? Which I think Dr. Sharma can enlighten us upon that. But it is important to do that. And you can do yoga every day. So you don't really have to do the physicalities, but you can also do the breathing part of it. And then, you know, spread it out over the week.
Dr. Rajinder, you recently celebrated the World Yoga Day. Tell me about that.
So it is 21st June is the International Yoga Day in the United Nations. Recommended in 2014 and 2015, the first Yoga Day was celebrated in New Delhi at the international level. And Dr. Seema, she represented Kenya at that international platform on that time. So Yoga Day, you see, we have the Father Day, Sister Day, Chocolate Day, Teddy Bear Day, like that, many Valentine Day. We have many days, but what about our own body, mind, and soul? What we are celebrating? So, Honorable Prime Minister of Republic of India, Mr. Modi, he proposed that to the this United Nations that we must have one International Yoga Day. At least whole world should know about it. It's our heritage. It's our heritage. We are maintaining it for the thousands and thousands of years. So United Nations accepted it. Then after United recommended in the United Nations General Assembly that 21st June. Recently we celebrated, and we are celebrating in Kenya since 2015 at the national level, and His Excellency High Commission of India, they are the one who are organizing each and every county, city, town of Kenya, and they support with the mats and the shirts like that. And this year we have we had around 3,000 people who came to celebrate this International Yoga Day at Premier Club. So we are thankful to His Excellency, High Commission of India, for organizing. And he is our one who is doing a great job to make our people to aware to this our heritage. And he celebrated this divine event.
Now, Dr. Seema, what are your organizations doing to ensure that more Kenyans uptake yoga?
We are going school to school. We are going to the hospitals and we are teaching there the breathing and the little exercise they can do it.
All right, so that's very fine. Dr. Rajinder, what are some of the movements that a beginner can do? Some of the yoga poses, like a very easy pose or movement that a beginner can do. Maybe the viewers at home want to see maybe one pose. Is it stretching or doing like this?
So so what I found in here in our local culture, that our people cannot sit at the ground in the cross leg position. Number one, because it's not the part of their movements from childhood till old age. So number one, they must sit at the ground in the cross leg position comfortably. Number one, and secondly, if you are working, you are at the chair from 8 to 1 and then 2 to 5, you must do your movement after every half an hour, and do some sit ups to mobilize your major joints of your body like ankle, knee, and hip. wrist, elbow, and shoulder. Mm-hmm. They're just stretches after for 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay. It can help you a lot. And the breathing, whenever you feel free, you must do the deep breathing.
Yeah.
Knowingly, unknowingly, we people are doing the wrong breathing. It is only the 10% of one breath.
Yeah.
You have to inhale deep and exhale completely.
Okay.
God has provided us oxygen in plenty in our environment, in our surroundings. We are getting it free of cost, and we don't expect. When we are in the hospital and we are paying thousands and thousands of shillings for 24 hours.
Mm-hmm. All right, well said. Now, Dr. Seema, meditation.
Yeah.
Does one have to hum during meditation? And
yeah, hum, yeah.
Hum.
And how natural is that?
Yeah.
Do I really have to hum? And
yeah.
what is the relevance of humming and meditating?
Humming meditation. You know, it relaxes the brains because it's the only meditation which can you don't have the thoughts on that time. When you're chanting this hum.
Mm-hmm.
So that time you don't have any thoughts in the brain.
Yeah,
mostly
yeah.
The people are complaining that yeah. when they are doing the meditation, they have the plenty of thoughts.
Yes.
So that's they can't do the meditation. But okay. when you're humming, giving the chanting, humming
yeah.
hums sound,
yeah.
you don't have the thoughts.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can children participate? And how young?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How young can a child, as young as... How many years?
Yeah, it is very easy. It's
mm-hmm.
very easy. You need to click
mm-hmm.
that how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you to explain the more benefits. Humming sound is the only one. It's a single breathing treatment for the paralysis.
Okay.
Lack of memory, loss of memory, dementia, Alzheimer diseases.
Mm-hmm.
20 cranial nerves are coming out of our brain.
Mm-hmm.
It tones up.
Mm-hmm.
As you grow old, at the age of 55 or 60, the government is going to give you the pension,
mm-hmm.
get the retirement, stay at home, because you have used your brain. Humming sound, it stops the degeneration of the brain cells, and it regenerates the brain cells, and very easy to do.
I can do a demo actually.
You have to cover.
Mm-hmm.
You have to cover your ear with the thumbs,
mm-hmm.
the finger,
yeah.
one finger covering your eye,
yeah.
the rest of your finger around your eyes.
Yeah.
You have to inhale deep.
Yeah.
Good. You do also.
Mm-hmm.
Then slow.
Okay, so now they're blocking out everything.
And you can... feel the sensation from her head.
Okay.
You just place your palm at her head,
yeah, yeah.
And you far aloud. No, place like this. Touch it.
Yeah.
Okay.
You feel the vibrations.
You will feel the vibration.
Yeah, because she's making a sound. So
yeah.
So definitely
it's a sound. And also, if you want to know the other benefit for the ladies,
mm-hmm.
it stops the premature wrinkles around your face.
Ah, so it has health and
yeah.
beauty benefits.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yes.
during this, alpha and theta waves are coming in the brain,
mm-hmm.
so it relaxes the brain. So it melts the stress also.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
But I want to know, for children, as young as how young? 3-year-olds, 4-year-olds, 7-year-olds, 10-year-olds?
No, 4-year-old children are doing.
Really?
Yeah.
I think we should also in Kenya
yeah.
incorporate this as a subject in school.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
you know,
mm-hmm.
we had physical education,
mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
So PE is what I know it as.
Yeah.
But I think it should be incorporated in schools as
yeah.
well.
Yeah.
It's very important to bring it up from the young ages, even 4,
yeah.
like they
yeah.
said,
yeah.
4 years old
yeah.
and over and above. So primary school
yeah.
is the right age to start.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Dr. Rajinda, depression has been rife in Kenya.
Mm.
Can yoga help?
Yes, only yoga can help. Mm-hmm. Only yoga can help. We have the special sessions for the mental illness, because it's not a disease, it's a state of mind.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
yeah.
So yoga, really wonderful. We have got the testimonials regarding this. Many psychiatrists are referring their clients to us people,
yeah.
you go and do the yoga and breathing pranayams.
Yeah.
So we are getting the benefits in the senior center for years. She knows very well that how many ladies,
yeah,
who are the single ones or widows one like that at,
yeah,
the old age, children are not taking care,
yeah,
and the medication is reduced.
Yeah, and what about psychosocial care? Because this has to be in tandem. Because yoga alone cannot do it. What is your take on the psychosocial support of patients who are under depression?
Like that, it's a counseling. With the counseling, in this the particular that they need to go for the counseling. Then after this, breathing, yoga, and passing that time with the good friends like that.
Okay, so now where exactly do you practice yoga?
Okay, well, we have this Moksha Yoga Studio.
Moksha Yoga.
Moksha means freedom.
Moksha is freedom.
Moksha means freedom from death and birth.
Okay.
When you leave the world,
yep,
you have to stay with the Almighty. You are not supposed to come back.
All right. So moksha.
You have to stay away from the materialistic world. It's the Moksha Yoga Studio.
And where is it located?
It's 95A Lemuru Road, Parklands.
Lemuru Road, Parklands, 95A.
Yes.
Yeah.
And other is our awakening group of yoga.
Yeah.
It's in the Parkland,
yeah,
at Patni Brotherhood.
So awakening group
of yoga. Fourth Parkland.
Parklands.
This is Sri Patni Brotherhood. It's a temple,
yeah,
of Patni community.
Yes.
So we are based there. We have the two. And the third one is at Aga Khan Jamaat Khana.
Aga Khan Jamaat.
And it's for the
pavilion.
Seniors.
Yes,
yeah,
the pavilion.
It's for the seniors.
All right.
And also we teach yoga at the oldest homes.
Yes.
Where the children had left their chair.
The older people, elderly people,
yes,
are
elderly
there.
People.
And you know, you just walk in there whenever you want, like,
yes, yes,
and say, okay, we're going to have, even if it's 10 minutes,
yeah,
and you can see them feel, you,
yes,
know, so rejuvenated,
yeah,
and the energy comes back, right?
All right.
So.
And also we do this laughter therapy.
Mm-hmm.
It's all only for 1 minute or two minutes like that.
What is laughter therapy?
Laughter therapy is... you see, you discuss this depression.
Mm-hmm.
I have seen that many people has forgotten how to laugh.
Yes.
How to smile.
Yes.
Okay. Only the frown face like this. Yes. So our class is so lively. Suppose Farah is doing something wrong in the class, then we will stop the class. Then I will tell Farah, do 5 times.
Yes. The latter.
No. any posture.
And, any posture. Okay.
And when Farah is taking her punishment and,
yes,
performing 5 times, the other women are laughing.
So it's automatic.
So it happens that their emotions are coming out.
Yes, yes, yes.
All the day you can't stay like this.
Okay.
Like that. You have to smile.
Yes.
Smiling is also,
right,
smiling and laughing,
right,
is also an emotion.
Dr. Regina, this conversation will continue. My director tells me that we're out of time. I just want last sentiments, beginning with you, Dr. Seema. Any last sentiments as we wrap this up?
I want that everyone can join with the yoga,
mm-hmm,
and do every day.
Yeah.
And everyone have the right to stay healthy and in the peace.
Okay.
So I want that everyone take the benefit of the yoga.
Yeah. All right, Farah, last sentiments, words?
Keep yogaing.
Okay.
Keep yogaing.
Yes.
Keep yogaing. That's all I will say.
Dr. Rajinder, last sentiments.
Last sentiment is that yoga is a way of life.
Yes.
And yoga is for life.
Mm-hmm.
You can read it here.
Hashtag yoga for life.
Yoga for life.
Mm-hmm.
Make yoga the, mm-hmm, part of your life.
Yeah.
Practice it minimum half an hour a day. Start with it.
Yes.
Start. Just take one initiative. Then you will be addicted. When you,
yes,
will get the benefits, you will be addicted to yoga.
Yes.
Many ladies, she has seen that 85 years old, they are coming with their drivers.
Mm-hmm.
So they are benefited. That's why they are coming.
Mm-hmm.
So devote at least minimum half an hour to your body.
Yeah.
And listen to your body.
All right. Thank you very much, Dr. Rajinder, Dr. Seema Farah, for gracing our studios
much.
And waking really early.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
very, 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 very much to invite us. And also thanks that you covered our
yes.
International Yoga Day at Patni Brotherhood.
Yes.
Well, we are very thankful to you. And we hope so soon we will be here again.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Yoga by Dr. Rajinder, Dr. Seema, and a practicing yoga artist, Farah.